Hey everyone, it is Josh here with HostGator. Today we're going to talk about Microsoft 365 or Office 365. I'm going to show you a little bit about this new product. So let's get started. I'm going to start out here inside of my HostGator customer portal. Now, if I want to access it on a specific hosting plan, the first thing I'm going to do is click on hosting. And that's going to take me to see all the packages that I have on this account. So I've got two, my cloud and my shared. I'm going to go through the shared today. And we'll click on manage. So if you've already purchased it, you would click manage, but the icon will also be here if you want to click purchase. Now, when you click purchase, it's actually going to walk you through the initial process of choosing the license that you want and also choosing your admin email. So I've already created my Josh at HGAdmin. The one thing I do want to note here is that in order to use Office 365, you're going to need to have your name servers pointed at HostGator. We've got an earlier video on our channel that will show you how to do this. Now, if it already pointed, what we're going to do is click on add email address. And the best way to think about adding an email address is that one license equals one seat or email address. And I'll show you a little bit about the licenses and the different types that we have for Office 365. So once you click on add email address, it's going to take you to a new section. And this is going to look very similar to the initial purchase section. So we're going to have to choose a subscription, and we've got three different options here. Now, the email essentials is basically what it sounds like. You're going to get the email sections for Office 365. So you're going to get the Outlook emails and calendars, and you're also going to get about 15 gigs of email storage space for each individual email that you choose. You can also choose the Business Plus or the Business Pro, and this is where Office 365 really kicks into high gear. With the Business Plus and Pro, you get access to the entire Microsoft Office suite, and you also get a 1 terabyte storage space for the OneDrive, which is essentially their cloud storage plan. We'll link a nice article with the different rates for these hosting plans and for the different options that they come with inside the video so you can get a better definition of it. So you can choose your plan here, and you can also choose as many email addresses or subscriptions as you want to. So if I wanted to add 2 seats for the email essentials, it will show exactly as how much it is per month. And as always, you're going to save a little bit of coin if you do the annual longer renewal. Let's head back to the customer portal, and I'll show you a little bit about how we can manage the initial admin email account and then log into our Microsoft portal. So as we mentioned, here is my admin account. It's Josh at HGAdmin. I've got the Business Pro subscription, and you can click here in the eye to give you a little bit more information about that. But if I want to click the manage section, I can do a few things as an administrator. I can remove myself as an admin or reset my password, and I can delete this user if I want to. So once you start managing multiple email addresses here inside the portal, this is a good section where you can do some quick actions. Now we've got some quick links here down at the bottom. We can show us how to set up the email on mobile or desktop, take a look at all the different applications that we have, and I'll move myself out of the way. If you purchase the option for the Office, then you can actually download those programs directly onto your computer. Now, what I want to do now is show you how to actually log into Office 365 through the portal. So what we're going to do is open up a new tab, and it's login.microsoftonline.com. And this is where we're going to put in the initial admin username. Click next, and then it's going to ask me for the password that I generated during signup. And now we are officially in the Office 365 portal. So this is where you'll manage your applications for the specific plan that you choose. If you have just the email essentials, you will have your Outlook and calendar here. But if you choose the Plus or the Pro, you're going to have a multitude of applications that you can choose from. We also have the ability to choose all of our current applications. You can look to use it through the webmail style application here by clicking on Outlook, and boom, you're in your inbox. Send emails, receive emails. I've got a test email sent for myself. Really easy to use, really quick and at your fingertips. So that's the Outlook and the essential exchange for mail. If we go back to here, you can look, and there's just a ton of applications in here that you can get used to. I hope you found this useful. As always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below and subscribe if you want to see more helpful videos. Thanks, y'all. Thank you.